So welcome. Church bells are sounding 8 o'clock right now. And I'm in Italia, in the dome. And the class that I have prepared for you is for the hips, for the liver meridian, so the inner thighs, the buttocks, the outer hips, and some twisting. And I don't know if you remember, but with the liver, the two emotions linked are anger and compassion. And remember that anger is an important emotion that we need to let flow through us, not suppress it and not react out of it. But it's not our focus today. But in case it comes up, we're going to turn towards compassion. And whatever's here, whatever comes up, any discomfort in the body, any uncomfortable emotion, any annoying thought, whatever is here, this spirit of friendliness, of inclusion, of this too I can include. So a compassion class where we target our hips. Beginning, as we always do, meditating, and I'll come back on my seat. Finding your posture, sitting or lying down. Closing your eyes. And welcoming yourself to this hour of compassion. This hour of time to connect with your body. Your heart, with your mind. And tuning into how do they feel right now? All these levels, all these arising and passing sensations, thoughts, and feelings. What's it like? Breathing into whatever's here. Radically including all of it. And then I invite you this class to think about somebody in your life that could use a little support, could use a dose of compassion. And energetically, if this feels authentic for you, gifting this practice to this person. So the intention is all of our practices are a support to ourselves and to others. This lovely being in your life that needs some more care, energetically letting them benefit from this class, offering it up to them. And we'll come into our first shape, which is lying butterfly. If you want a pillow, have a pillow under your head. Target area is the inner thighs. Your feet further in front or closer together. Play with it, even if you know this posture really well. It can change, there's different nuances there. We'll be holding it for 5 minutes.
starting now. And the arms were as comfortable to your sides or resting on your belly center, your heart. Back of the neck long, shoulders relaxed. Your entire face relaxed. Being the first yin posture of the class. Concentrate on landing into it, allowing it to be here. Allow yourself to be in the shape. And with each and every exhale, softening more and more. Of course, if it becomes too much, you can come out of the shape. You can always take your fists and put it under the legs, and the other legs is letting to rest on the blocks. Quiet tongue, soft throat, relaxed jaw. And wear your breath all the way down to the belly. And every exhale is wonderful opportunity to relax more. To feel the shape. To be held by my voice, by your practice, by the earth. If anything percolates up that's uncomfortable, not ignoring it, but turning towards it with compassion, with care and curiosity. And at first not needing to figure it out or change it, but instead just welcoming it here. Understanding that it has its reasons for being here. It's a call to attend. So attending to it with your attention. And if nothing uncomfortable is here, and you can fully relax in the shape, then please fully relax in the shape. Letting there be a gentleness this moment. A the shape, you might want to take your hands to help the knees forward, and maybe it's fine. Pause here. How's this rehab? What are you aware of energetically, or physically, or emotionally, or mentally? What are you aware of? We stay with the inner thighs as the target, but the last one is more of a back bend, and then we come into more of a fore bend for happy baby. So either holding onto your feet, with the feet in together, or you can hold onto the knees, or bringing the feet up. Targets the inner thighs. And I know for some people, holding like this can be uncomfortable for the shoulders, so another alternative would be to come forward in butterfly. So fore bend, inner thigh stretch, either in butterfly, or a gentle inversion, happy baby. And feel free to explore with straight legs or bent legs, the angle of your feet to find that sweet spot. The sweet spot's not always sweet, it can be a little uncomfortable. And when you've found your shape, whether it's butterfly or happy baby, being here. Breathing consciously. And with the exhale, softening consciously. Anything that stops you from softening, from relaxing, turning towards that with compassion, with care. Not hardening against what you don't want. But going, oh, this is what's here. This is what needs meeting. This is what needs care. Okay, I can do that. There's a confidence I find into compassion. Like, believing in ourselves, yeah, we can meet whatever life throws at us. I believe that wholeheartedly. Individually and collectively. It won't be easy, but we can meet whatever comes. If you're holding tension, and if you can release it. So areas we tend to hold tension, so forehead, the jaw, shoulders. Maybe it's possible to relax a little more. here, caring for what's here, here. Maybe you want to exhale a little more, consciously releasing any blocked energy on any of the planes. You breathe out through your mouth. One more longer, deeper exhale. And then slowly release. Resting on your back, feeling the rebound. So with that bright curiosity, what's going on inside of you right now? With that steady confidence, trusting you can meet whatever is going on inside of you. Gently coming up to sitting for a sitting twist. And you can either have one leg straight, one leg bent, and turn towards your leg. Or if your bones allow it, you can come into a shoelace and twist. So shoelace is where the knees are on top of each other. It's good for some people, not good for others. We're choosing one leg up, or do you fold the other leg behind, keep the knee up, or even down. We'll hold the twist for 3 minutes. Twisting towards your top leg or bent leg. Letting the sitting bones ground. The head float up. Let there be a lightness, a softness to the throat, to the neck. Drop the shoulder blades, widen through the chest. Looking however far behind is okay for your neck. And twists are that squeezing out, really helping with the detox, helping with released stuck energy. Helping letting go what's not helping, what's draining you down. Okay, here, maybe you need a little help to go. And compassion can manifest like that in this act of doing. So this act of twist. Fantastic massage for your organs. Incredible nourishment for the spine. Do check that there's no strain in the shoulders, the throat, the neck. Feel free to gently lengthen the exhale. And if there's some space, twist a millimeter further into it. And if there's no more space, then stay. what's here now and how you're turning towards it. One more breath, maybe the end, exhale, squishing a little further. Inhale, coming up. Untwist the legs, but notice which way the legs are. Leaning back, beach pose. Opening through the chest, the heart. It's comfortable through the throat as you lean the head back. You stay where you are. I just turn because I don't like to turn my back to you. Then twisting the other side. So bending the other leg and twisting back, either the knee up or folding the leg behind me up or down. Remembering, we're saying the same things over and over, but we're still not symmetrical. It hasn't changed. So since we're not symmetrical, find what's appropriate in this side. Relax the shoulders, open through the collarbones, let the head float up, back the neck long, throat soft. And in this direction, the act of squeezing out, stuck, stagnant, unhelpful energy. Helping your body along. And appreciating your body for all it does for you. Maybe on the exhales, a millimeter more into the twist. Maybe that's not available. No force, no violence. Rather gentle exploration. Kind awareness. How was this experience and how are you meeting it? One more breath here, maybe twisting a little more the exhale. Inhale, come out. Lean back into beach pose. Stretching, spreading the front of the body. How does this feel? coming down, lying down. We'll come into figure four, so again, the pillow may be helpful. Figure four is targeting the buttocks, the IT band. Either you cross the ankle over the knee, that's enough, or you hold, or maybe it's more effective to cross the knee over the knee, so more of a shoelace, and you hug yourself here. So choosing tight figure four or wide figure four. For some bodies, both are effective. For other bodies, only one of the two is effective. So what's it like for your body? And taking time to decide, to feel into, what's it going to be this practice? And then, also again, the neck. So smooth the back, the neck's long. Do you need a pillow? So, please give yourself one. If you have furniture or wall, you can always rest your foot on the wall or on a chair. And letting the back of the body widen on the exhale. Spreading, releasing. It's 8:30 here. Corner sofa in Italy. Oh, how I love church bells. And hopefully the vibrations of the bells, whether you heard them or not, are rippling all the way over to you. We'll explore in physics a butterfly's flap in Italy, for example, can cause a storm or can blow a storm away somewhere else, say Vancouver or Calgary or Auckland, I don't know. And so everything is so deeply connected, deeply intertwined. And everything is deserving of our care. And anything, everything that is not okay is deserving of our compassion. And compassion is one of the four immeasurables, meaning it's endless. There's no end to compassion. Once we tune into our compassionate nature, we can keep offering ourselves and one another and the planet more and more of it, without exhausting ourselves, without depleting. And that's where we tune into that, I find, is a confidence that comes. This trust that we can meet, we can attend to. Just seeing how that resonates with you right now. you like, letting the exhale lengthen. Helping move energy, releasing it. The last few breaths here. One more breath. Long exhalation. And releasing it. Uncrossing the legs, feeling the difference from the one side to the other. Feeling the energy flow. And then coming to the other side. So crossing the other ankle over or the knee. Two sides still are asymmetrical. So what's it like if you can play, even if you always do a wide figure four, you can see, oh, does a narrow figure four work for this side of my body or not? Especially because we're holding them for 5 minutes, take the first half a minute or more to discover, explore, and then settle into the shape. So no automatic pilot. No, I know the shape and I'm gonna do it. Each and every time, oh, what do I have this time? And how can I be with myself, my tissues, my cells, my sensations. How can I be with them all with gentleness, with kindness, with compassion? And if it's all feeling wonderful, then of course, being with it with joy. And scanning the body for any places that hold tension. Forehead, eyes, jaw, tongue, throat, shoulders. And whatever's possible to let go, let go. And whatever tension can't be let go of, holding it compassionately. With a sense of, oh, this is here now. Okay, hello this. Hello now. And if you like, lengthen the exhales, helping the energy flow, helping the inner knots untie themselves. One more breath. And gently releasing. Back into the rebound shape. Shavasana. Feeling what's going on. We'll come into a lion twist. Relationship of the hip and the shoulders. Bend the knees, bring them close towards you, over to one side, padding under or between the legs, padding behind your shoulder. The head can turn right or left, or stay straight up. Legs can straighten or stay bent. Again, that same principle of the first half a minute to a minute. It's time to discover, readjust, and settle into your twist. And then hang out in your twist. Held by life. Supported by the earth. Deeply interconnected with everything. Resting in the magic and mystery of that. And of course, anything that comes up is uncomfortable. Holding it lovingly. You would hold child, the pet, the dear one, holding yourself with love. going on now? And how are you relating to it? And the how you're relating to it is so much more important than the what's going on. One more breath here. Inhale, coming out. Pausing, feeling, allowing. And then twisting to the other side. So hug the legs in towards you, bring them one direction and the shoulders the other. I turn it around again so I can twist towards you. And see, yeah, what's needed on this side. Pillows or blankets. Under, between the legs, behind the shoulder. What's the right angle for your head? And the twist, that relationship of hips and shoulders, so as long as they're twisting in different directions, you're doing it. And then rest in it. The goodness of the shape. The goodness of life, of earth support. The goodness of this moment now, like this. curious to rebound. If you like hugging your legs in towards you, you can roll your head side to side. You can circle the legs around, massaging the lower back, the organs. You can do anything you'd like to do before the next shape, which is Shavasana. Anything that your body desires, go for it. And then, when you're ready, lying down on your back. Blanket, pillows, whatever support. Then legs roll in or out. Back or neck long. Arms resting either on your belly or to your sides. Feeling your body's contact with the floor beneath you, and maybe with the earth beneath the floor. This beautiful invitation from the shape to fully let go. Completely allow whatever's here to be here, without getting busy with it. And to rest in that incredible interconnectedness of all things. Incredible spaciousness. Deep within us and all around us. does your body feel and what's your relationship to your body right now? How's your heart? And what's your relationship to your heart right now? And how's your mind? What's your relationship with your mind right now? Gently, lovingly make your way up to sitting. Bring your hands together. May our minds be clear and insightful. May our hearts be warm, courageous, and compassionate. And may we be grounded in presence. I'm sending a blessing off to the person you thought of to dedicate this class to. May he or she be well. May they feel your support, your love. Namaste.